Welcome back, everyone. My name is Edwin, also known as SOLIDSNAKEee, and today I'm going to be playing Mass Effect, the first game, not the second or third, even though I didn't finish my second playthrough. We'll get to that in a moment. Mass Effect Andromeda is coming out in a few months, and I thought it'd be a great idea to actually, you know, go through the games and just sort of get back into them. As you may have noticed, I had a Mass Effect 2 playthrough, and I didn't finish that because reasons and other reasons that I'm not going to get into. But long and short of it, Mass Effect 1. Let's jump into it. There's going to be some other stuff. If you hear any background noise, that's probably family, so I apologize for that. Second thing, this is going to be a long play, not like a let's play or a playthrough where you cut it into pieces. I'm actually just going to upload like one chunk, maybe of like 1 or 2 hours, maybe, well, depending on how long I record for. For this one, I'm probably going to record for about 2 hours, cut out all the boring stuff because Mass Effect 1 can be a little bit grindy and tedious. But aside from that, gonna jump right into this and start a biotic build because I haven't done that before, unless we're talking about Mass Effect 3 multiplayer. But that's a different story.
Welcome to Alliance Military Database.
Hello.
Classified information requested.
That's always top secret stuff.
Establishing secure connection.
That's a good idea.
Secure connection confirmed.
Awesome. John Shepard. Enter new ID. Yeah, we'll keep John Shepard. John.
Please log in to access your profile.
Accept.
Profile reconstruction complete.
Okay. I do not want the Earthborn stuff.
Please log in to access your profile reconstruction complete.
Press edit, B to go back, because I don't want that stuff. Gonna go for Mail Shep, because Mail Shep.
Please log in to access your profile.
Verifying username.
Warning, data corruption detected.
Ruh-roh.
Please reconstruct profile. Confirm pre-service history.
Earthborn. You guys can read all of that.
Confirm psychological profile.
War hero, because I'm not a dick.
Confirm military specialization.
Adapt, I believe it is, the biotic. We will go with shotgun.
Confirm facial identification.
Confirm.
Profile reconstruction complete.
Bip, bap, wham.
Identification confirmed.
We'll keep this all normal for now. Just for convenience sake. So when there's going to be audio and discussion and things like that, I'm going to not try to talk over it because reasons.
Well, what about Shepard? Earthborn? No record of his family.
Doesn't have one. He was raised on the streets, learned to look out for himself.
He proved himself during the Blitz. Held off enemy forces on the ground until reinforcements arrived.
He's the only reason Elysium is still standing.
We can't question his courage.
Humanity needs a hero, and Shepard's the best we've got.
I'll make the call.
In the year 2148, explorers of Mars discovered the remains of an ancient Spacerian civilization, and decades that followed, these mysterious artifacts reveal startling new technologies enabling travel to the farther stars. The basis for this incredible technology was a force that controlled the very fabric of space and time. They called it the greatest discovery in human history. The civilizations of the galaxy called it Mass Effect. It's actually to do with dark energy. Try to not beat the crap out of my pop filter.
The Arcturus Prime relay is in range. Initiating transmission sequence.
Commander. Hey, look, Neptune.
We are connected. Calculating transit mass and destination. The relay is hot. Acquiring approach vector. All stations secure for transit.
Thank you.
the screen. Approach run has begun.
The Mass Effect relays. That's the only time that loading screen is important.
Thrusters, check. Navigation,
until the second game.
Check. Internal emissions sync engaged. All systems online. Drift, just under 1,500K.
1,500 is good. Your captain will be pleased.
I hate that guy.
Nihlus gave you a compliment. So you hate him.
You remember to zip up your jumpsuit on the way out of the bathroom? That's good. I just jumped us halfway across the galaxy and hit a target the size of a pinhead. So that's incredible. Besides, Spectres are trouble. I don't like having them on board. Call me paranoid.
You're paranoid. The Council helped fund this project. They have a right to send someone to keep an eye on their investment.
Yeah, that is the official story. But only an idiot believes the official story.
I agree. I'm also doing a Paragon playthrough, so not a dick.
They don't send Spectres on shakedown runs.
So there's more going on here than the captain's letting on.
Joker, status report.
Just cleared the mass relay, Captain. Stealth systems engaged. Everything looks solid.
Good. Find a comm buoy and link us into the network. I want mission reports relayed back to Alliance Brass before we reach Eden Prime.
Aye, aye, Captain. Better brace yourself, sir. I think Nihlus is headed your way.
He's already here, Lieutenant. Tell Commander Shepard to meet me in the comm room for a debriefing.
You get that, Commander?
Is he upset?
He sounds angry. Something must have gone wrong with the mission.
Captain always sounds like that when he's talking to me.
Can't possibly imagine why.
Okay, I am going to... Yeah, it's just telling me a bunch of stuff. I'm going to up the brightness a little bit if I can do that. Display settings. I can't. That's annoying. Well, we'll fix it next time.
I'm telling you, I just saw him. He marched by like he was on a mission.
He's a Spectre, and they're always on a mission.
And we're getting dragged. Right along with him.
Relax, Presley. You're gonna give yourself an ulcer.
Engineer Adams.
Congratulations, Commander. Looks like we had a smooth run. You heading down to see the captain?
I heard you arguing.
Sounds like you don't trust our Turian guest.
Sorry, Commander. Just having a chat with Adams down at Engineering. I didn't mean to cause any trouble. But you have to admit, something's odd about this mission. The whole crew feels it.
What do you mean?
You think the Alliance Brass is holding out on us?
If all we're supposed to do is test out the stealth system, why is Captain Anderson in charge? And then there's Nihlus. Spectres are elite operatives, top covert agents. Why send a Spectre, a Turian Spectre, on a shakedown run? It doesn't add up.
So basically, after every conversation, well, for some conversations, you'll get this investigate thing, and that's like your next line of questioning, just so you can understand more things. These are actually your options for continuing, like, dialogue and progressing with that conversation. So if I was to progress with the conversation, I would not get these options, or at least for most conversations.
What do you know about the stealth systems?
I just know it masks our location from scans and sensors. Cutting-edge technology. The Normandy's the only ship with this prototype drive. But why are we fully staffed? A skeleton crew would be cheaper. Less chance of security leaks, too. Plus, there's Nihlus. It's pretty obvious this shakedown run is just a cover.
A cover?
For what?
Damned if I know, Commander. We're out here on false pretenses. I'm not a fan of being left in the dark.
I can understand that.
Do you have a problem with the captain?
No, sir. But I can't figure out what he's doing here. Captain Anderson is one of the most decorated Special Forces officers in the service. If he melted down all his medals, he could make a life-size statue of himself. You don't send a soldier like that on a do-nothing mission. He's treating this shakedown run too seriously. Something big is going on.
Damn straight it is.
You don't trust Nihlus.
I don't like Turians in general. It runs in my family. My grandfather fought in the First Contact War, lost a lot of friends when the Turians hit us.
That was a long time ago.
That was 30 years ago. You can't blame Nihilus for that.
No, I guess not. But it still makes me nervous to have a Spectre on board, especially a Turian. We're an Alliance vessel, human military, but Nihilus doesn't answer to the captain like the rest of us. Spectres operate outside the normal chain of command. And they don't come along just to observe shakedown runs. Nihilus looks like he's expecting some heavy action. I don't like it.
I'll look into it.
I'll see if I can get some answers when I see him.
Good luck, Commander.
Also, Presley is a super fucking racist, so.
I grew up on Eden Prime, Doc. It's not the kind of place Spectres visit. There's something Nihilus isn't telling us about this mission.
That's crazy. The captain's in charge here. He wouldn't take orders from a Spectre.
Not his choice, Doc. Spectres don't answer to anyone. They can do whatever they want. Kill anyone who gets in their way.
Oh, you watch too many spy vids, Jenkins.
Goddamn it, Jenkins.
What do you think, Commander? We won't be staying on Eden Prime too long, will we? I'm itching for some real action.
I sincerely hope you're kidding, Corporal. Your real action usually ends with me patching up crew members in the infirmary.
You need to calm down, Corporal. A good soldier stays cool, even under fire.
Sorry, Commander, but this waiting's killing me. I've never been on a mission like this before, not one with a Spectre on board.
You'll be fine. Nihilus.
What can you tell me about Nihilus?
Turians are generally well-respected by the other species. Their fleet has more patrols protecting Citadel space than any other. They don't always get on well with us, though. Some people find them too rigid. Others still blame them for the First Contact War. As for Nihilus, I haven't said more than two words to him. He usually only speaks to the captain.
I heard Nihilus once took down an entire enemy platoon all by himself. Man, I can't believe I'm on a mission with an actual Spectre.
Ah, Jenkins. You're so idealistic.
What do you know about the Spectres?
Only what I've heard. Spectre agents work directly for the Citadel Council. They usually work alone or in small groups. Spectres don't have any official power, though. Basically, they're a shadow organization with a mandate to preserve and protect galactic stability.
Protect it at any cost. Don't forget that part. Spectres operate above the law.
There are no human Spectres?
Why don't we have any of our own people in there?
Spectres usually come from the council races, like the Turians. We've been trying to get a human accepted into their ranks for years now. So far, it hasn't happened.
Hey, Commander, you'd make a good Spectre. You're a war hero, right? Held off an entire enemy fleet during the Blitz single-handed? That's the kind of talent the Spectres are looking for.
This is all just wild speculation. The Spectres aren't interested in recruiting humans, no matter how capable.
Uh-huh.
You're from Eden Prime, aren't you, Jenkins? What's it like?
It's very peaceful, Commander. They've been real careful with development, so you don't have any city noise or pollution. My parents lived on the outskirts of the colony. At night, I used to climb this big hill and stare across the fields back at the lights from the main settlement. It was gorgeous. But when I got older, I realized it was a little too calm and quiet for me. That's why I joined the Alliance. Even Paradise gets boring after a while.
Why are we going there?
Any idea why Eden Prime was chosen as our destination?
Not really sure, Commander. Eden Prime's one of our most stable colonies. Good place to take the Normandy for a shakedown run, I guess. No real danger there. There's gotta be something else going on. We've got a Spectre on board. That's why I'm so wound up. I can't wait for the real mission to start.
Oh, you'll be fine.
Just treat this like every other assignment you've had and everything will work out.
Easy for you to say. You proved yourself in the Blitz. Everybody knows what you can do. This is my big chance. I need to show the brass what I can do.
Be careful.
You're young, Corporal. You have a long career ahead of you. Don't do something stupid to mess it up.
Don't worry, sir. I'm not going to screw this up.
Okay.
The captain's waiting for me.
Goodbye, Commander. Yes, Commander, is there something you need?
The captain's waiting for me.
Forgot, there's not
Goodbye,
a whole
Commander.
Lot of dialogue in, or with your crewmates in ME1. Nihilus. Oh, hi.
Commander Shepard, I was hoping you'd get here first. It will give us a chance to talk.
Where's Captain Anderson?
The captain said he'd meet me here.
He's on his way. I'm interested in this world we're going to, Eden Prime. I've heard it's quite beautiful.
Beyond beautiful.
They say it's a paradise.
Yes, a paradise. Serene, tranquil, safe. Eden Prime has become something of a symbol for your people, hasn't it? Proof that humanity can not only establish colonies across the galaxy, but also protect them. But how safe is it, really?
Why are you asking?
Do you know something?
Your people are still newcomers, Shepard. The galaxy can be a very dangerous place. Is the Alliance truly ready for this?
I think it's about time we told the Commander what's really going on.
Oh, snap.
This mission is far more than a simple shakedown run.
I knew it.
I figured there was something you weren't telling us.
We're making a covert pickup on Eden Prime. That's why we needed the stealth systems operational.
Why the secrecy? You should have told me. What are we picking up?
There must be a reason you didn't tell me about this, sir.
This comes down from the top, Commander. Information strictly on a need-to-know basis. A research team on Eden Prime unearthed some kind of beacon during an excavation. It was Prothean.
Prothean?
I thought the Protheans vanished 50,000 years ago.
Their legacy still remains. The mass relays, the Citadel, our ship drives. It's all based on Prothean technology.
This is big, Shepard. The last time humanity made a discovery like this, it jumped our technology forward 200 years. But Eden Prime doesn't have the facilities to handle something like this. We need to bring the beacon back to the Citadel for proper study.
Obviously, this goes beyond mere human interests, Commander. This discovery could affect every species in Council space.
Why did we tell the Council? Glad you're here to help. See, that seems like a dick thing to say, so I'm not gonna be a dick and say that.
It never hurts to have a few extra hands on board.
The beacon's not the only reason I'm here, Shepard.
Nihlus wants to see you in action, Commander. He's here to evaluate you.
I should have known.
Guess that explains why I bump into him every time I turn around.
The Alliance has been pushing for this for a long time. Humanity wants a larger role in shaping interstellar policy. We want more say with the Citadel Council. The Spectres represent the Council's power and authority. If they accept a human into their ranks, it shows how far the Alliance has come.
You held off an enemy assault during the Blitz single-handed. You showed not only courage, but also incredible skill. That's why I put your name forward as a candidate for the Spectres.
You put my name forward?
Why would a Turian want a human in the Spectres?
Not all Turians resent humanity. Some of us see the potential of your species. We see what you have to offer to the rest of the galaxy, and to the Spectres. We are an elite group. It's rare to find an individual with the skills we seek. I don't care that you're human, Shepard. I only care that you can do the job.
See, I like Nihlus.
I assume this is good for the Alliance.
Earth needs this, Shepard. We're counting on you.
I need to see your skills for myself, Commander. Eden Prime will be the first of several missions together.
You'll be in charge of the ground team. Secure the beacon and get it onto the ship ASAP. Nihlus will accompany you to observe the mission.
Protheans.
What do you know about the Protheans?
Just what they taught us in school. They were a technologically advanced species that ruled the galaxy 50,000 years ago. Then they vanished. Nobody really knows how or why, though I've heard plenty of theories. But everyone agrees, galactic civilization wouldn't exist without them.
Their citadel is the very heart of galactic society, and without their mass relays, interstellar travel would be impossible. We all owe the Protheans a great debt.
Eden Prime.
I'd like to know more about Eden Prime before we touch down.
It's a peaceful farming world, but it represents something much bigger. Eden Prime is one of our oldest and most successful colonies. It proved we were ready to face the challenges of settling new worlds, to forge a place for humanity beyond Earth. It symbolizes humanity's growth and evolution as a spacefaring species. And after this, it will be known as the world where humans made a discovery of galactic importance.
Yay! Beacon.
Why is this beacon so important?
All advanced galactic civilization is based on Prothean technology, even yours.
If we hadn't discovered those Prothean ruins buried on Mars, we'd still be stuck on Earth. That was just a small data cache. Who knows what we can learn from this beacon? What if it's a weapons archive? We can't let it fall into the wrong hands.
Wrong hands? Pirates? Krogans?
Like who?
The Attican Traverse isn't the most stable sector of Citadel space. There are plenty of raiders and criminal groups active in the region. They might figure a Prothean beacon is worth the risk of attacking an Alliance ship. Plus, Eden Prime is right on the border of the Terminus systems.
Was it me, or does he like look blind in one eye just whenever he's talking? It's weird.
The Attic and Traverse is under Citadel protection. If the Terminus systems attack, it's an act of war.
Technically, yes. But some of the species in the Terminus might be willing to start a war over this.
The last thing the Council wants is to get dragged into a major conflict with the Terminus systems. We have to keep this low-key.
Okay, I'm ready to go.
Just give the word, Captain.
We should be getting close to Eden.
Captain, we got a problem.
What's wrong, Joker?
Transmission from Eden Prime, sir. You better see this.
Bring it up on screen.
Get down!
We are under attack, taking heavy casualties! I repeat, heavy casualties! We can't... An evac! They came out of nowhere! We need...
traffic at all. It just goes dead. There's nothing.
Reverse and hold at 38.5. Status report.
17 minutes out, Captain. No other Alliance ships in the area.
Take us in, Joker. Fast and quiet. This mission just got a lot more complicated.
A small strike team can move quickly without drawing attention. It's our best chance to secure the beacon.
Grab your gear and meet us in the cargo hold. Tell Alenko and Jenkins to suit up, Commander. You're going in.
Giant space lobsters. Let's go.
Engaging stealth systems. Somebody was doing some serious digging here, Captain.
Your team's the muscle in this operation, Commander. Go in heavy and head straight for the dig site.
What about survivors, Captain?
Helping survivors is a secondary objective. The beacon's your top priority.
Approaching drop point one.
Nihilus, you coming with us?
I move faster on my own.
YOLO.
Nihilus will scout out ahead. He'll feed you status reports throughout the mission. Otherwise, I want radio silence.
He can count on us.
We've got his back, Captain.
The mission's yours now, Shepard. Good luck!
We are approaching drop point two.
Accuracy, blah blah blah.
What the hell are those? Damn!
Party balloons.
Area secure.
Okay, I think A is the sprint.
I think we got it.
Squad. Warp. Roll Warper, I suppose those are the two I'm gonna go with. That's to make me more tanky. Charm. I'm looking to level my Paragon stuff first. Barrier. Toxic shields. So this is one thing about Mass Effect. You basically explore everything. You have to go this way, you go the other way. so you can't miss the 11. That makes sense. Switch weapons for your squad mates. Ah, okay. I know we were running downward. Is that the Lancer or is that the Avenger? Okay. The Lancer comes into play in Mass Effect Reno. Oh no, Jenkins. Let's see. Gotta figure out how to zoom. And I honest to God can. Still trying to figure it out.
Rip right through his shields. You're out of chance.
He deserves a burial.
We'll see that he receives a proper service once the mission is complete. But I need you to stay focused.
Aye, aye, sir.
Paragon. I want to see how to aim. Okay, that's crouch. Let's move forward. That's character commands. Metagel Omnigel throughout the game by defeating enemies and opening containers. Metagel is necessary to heal injured squad members. Omnigel is needed to use encryption electronics. Trying to get used to the controls again.
I've got some burned out buildings here, Shepard. A lot of bodies. I'm gonna check it out. I'll try to catch up with you at the dig site.
Roger, Dodger. Coil dampener. I believe I leveled up again, didn't I? Just put everything into persuasion. Basic armor, dude. No, light armor. That would be important. Warp. Throw. I should probably do Kitten as well, shouldn't I? Forget how to aim. Who's over here? Do I have barrier? I don't. Ashley. Try this again. Unfriend. Is that why I can't be moving? Because I'm trying left trigger on that.
Gunnery Chief Ashley Williams of the 212. You the one in charge here, sir?
Are you okay?
Are you wounded, Williams?
A few scrapes and burns. Nothing serious. The others weren't so lucky. Oh, man. We were patrolling the perimeter when the attack hit. We tried to get off a distress call, but they cut off our communications. I've been fighting for my life ever since.
Fighting these things? What happened to your unit?
Where's the rest of your squad?
We tried to double back to the beacon, but we walked into an ambush. I don't think any of the others... I think I'm the only one left.
Don't blame yourself.
This isn't your fault, Williams. You couldn't have done anything to save them.
Yes, sir. We held our position as long as we could, until the Geth overwhelmed us.
The Geth haven't been seen outside the Vale in nearly 200 years. Why are they here now?
They must have come for the beacon. The dig site is close, just over that rise. It might still be there.
Join us.
We could use your help, Williams.
Aye, aye, sir. It's time for payback.
Geth.
What else do you know about the Geth?
Just what I remember from history class back in school. They're synthetics, non-organic life forms with limited AI programming, created by the Quarians a few centuries ago. They were supposed to be a source of cheap labor, but ended up turning on the Quarians and drove them into exile. Well, after that, they just kind of disappeared behind the Perseus Veil. Nobody's really heard much from them since.
Beacon.
Tell me everything you know about the beacon.
They were doing some digging out here to extend the monorail and expand the colony. A few weeks ago, they unearthed some Prothean ruins and the beacon. Suddenly, every scientific expert in the colony was interested. That's when they brought us in to secure the site. I don't know much about the beacon itself, but I heard one of the researchers say this could be the biggest scientific discovery of the century.
And the scientists? Scientists?
What happened to the researchers at the dig site?
I don't know. They set up camp near the beacon. The 232 was with them. Maybe their unit fared better than mine.
Before the attack.
Describe what happened leading up to the attack.
We were sent out a couple of nights ago from the main colony to secure the area. Seemed like a routine patrol, until the Geth hit us. We never knew they were coming.
The scientists?
What happened to the researchers at the dig site?
I don't know.
Oh.
They set up camp near the beacon.
The
232 was with them. Maybe their unit fared better than mine.
Have you seen a Turian Spectre around here?
There aren't any Turians on Eden Prime. None that I've ever met. Not sure I'd be able to tell if one was a Spectre anyway.
If you saw this guy, you'd know. Carries enough firepower to wipe out a whole platoon. Luckily, he's on our side.
Sorry. Like I said, no Turians.
Okay, let's go.
Move out.
The beacon's at the far end of this trench.
Squad. You can have assault rifle training. Anything else I missed? Let's talk to them. Okay. Autobots, roll out. Back for grenades. Wait for time detonation.
Finally, some action!
So we're actually spread at high speed for short distances. Wow. There was no cover in Mass Effect 1. That's right. Okay, so yeah, it is left trigger, it's just because I'm on screen. Row. Oh, I forgot how terrible the combo system in this game is. So bad.
Think we're good, Commander. This is the dig site. The beacon was right here. It must have been moved.
By who? Our side or the Geth?
Hard to say. Maybe we'll know more after we check out the research camp.
Any survivors?
You think anyone got out of here alive?
If they were lucky. Maybe hiding up in the camp. It's just on the top of this ridge, up the ramps.
Roger, Dodger. Well, I leveled up. Which means barrier, because that's actually going to be useful. Basic armor wouldn't hurt either. Caden. Electronics. Oh yeah, Ashley. Well, that's, she's actually not going to be important. She is not going to be important for this playthrough. I do not believe. Assault rifles, combat armor. Because there's achievements for going through like 60% of the game or something like that. 60 missions.
There's a small spaceport up ahead. I want to check it out. I'll wait for you there.
There's like 60 missions in the game or 60 quests. And basically you need to go through the entirety of it with like two teammates, two squad mates. So for this playthrough, I'm going to take Kaden and
we should move, Commander.
Rex. Because Rex. I have no idea where the hell I'm meant to be going. I would assume, according to the radar, it's back this way. And yeah. Wait, is it not letting me advance until I? Oh god damn it.
It used to be beautiful here.
Okay, crouching. And here or something. I have no idea where the hell we're meant to be going. Map. There, camp, dig site. Turn right. I'm going the right way. I'm just a dumbass. Oh, that's convenient. Oh, those two are down there. Nope, still a dumbass. That would be Maya barking. Maya's my dog. Pride and joy. Love her to bits, but she can be a real bitch. So all of this like boring stuff, I'm probably gonna cut out. Or cut out in future episodes.
Looks like they hit the camp hard.
It's a good place for an ambush. Keep your guard up.
Those look fucked up.
Oh god, they're still alive.
What did the Geth do to them?
Error 404, file not found. Just EMP? Oh. Well, that's gotta be tedious. You can use overload. I'm going to... run like hell. The loading, please.
Bag him and tag him.
Metagel, please. Open crate. Drew, reduce. Oh, hi.
Humans. Thank the Maker.
Hurry. Close the door before they come back.
You're safe.
Don't worry. We'll protect you.
Thank you. I think we'll be okay now. It looks like everyone's gone.
You're Dr. Warren, the one in charge of the excavation. Do you know what happened to the beacon?
It was moved to the spaceport this morning. Manuel and I stayed behind to help pack up the camp. When the attack came, the Marines held them off long enough for us to hide. They gave their lives to save us.
No one is saved. The age of humanity is ended. Soon, only ruin and corpses will remain.
Ah.
What else can you tell me about the attack?
It all happened so fast. One second we were gathering up our equipment. The next we were hiding in the shed while the Geth swarmed over the camp.
Agents of the destroyers. Bringers of darkness. Heralds of our extinction.
We could hear the battle outside. Gunfire, screams. I thought it would never end. Then everything went quiet. We just sat there, too afraid to move, until you came along.
Nihilus.
Did you notice a Turian in the area?
I saw him, the Prophet, leader of the enemy. He was here before the attack.
That's impossible. Nihilus was with us in the Normandy before the attack. He couldn't have been here.
I'm sorry, Manuel's still a bit unsettled. We haven't seen your Turian. We've been hiding in here since the attack.
Okay. Beacon.
Can you tell me anything about the beacon?
It's some type of data module from a galaxy-wide communications network. Remarkably well-preserved. It could be the greatest scientific discovery of our lifetime. Miraculous new technologies, groundbreaking medical advances. Who knows what secrets are locked inside?
We have unearthed the heart of evil. Awakened the beast. Unleashed the darkness.
Manuel, please. This isn't the time.
The great thing about this is, he's completely correct.
What's wrong with your assistant?
Manuel has a brilliant mind, but he's always been a bit unstable. Genius and madness are two sides of the same coin.
Is it madness to see the future? To see the destruction rushing towards us? To understand there is no escape? No hope? No. I am not mad. I'm the only sane one left.
I gave him an extra dose of his meds after the attack.
I can shut him up. Nah.
Williams, take us to the spaceport.
You can't stop it. Nobody can stop it. Night is falling. The darkness of eternity.
Hush, Manuel. Go lie down. You'll feel better once the medication kicks in.
Okay. See? Paragon. Okay. Let's get moving. Wasn't there another crib? Yeah. Or is that Metagel? No, it's another crib. Heavy human. Reduced Omnigel. Man, I believe that's it. So, let's get moving. Swiggity, swiggity, let's move that booty. Another cutscene.
Saren. Nihilus.
This isn't your mission, Saren. What are you doing here?
The Council thought you could use some help on this one.
Now, wasn't expecting to find the Geth here. The situation's bad.
Don't worry. I've got it under control.
That answers that question.
What is that? Off in the distance.
It's a ship. Look at the size of it.
It's a lobster. This is going to be a fun game to do on insane difficulty. More survivors.
Everybody stay calm out there. We're coming out, we're not armed.
Is it safe? Are they gone?
It's safe.
You're okay now. Nobody's going to hurt you.
Those things were crawling all around the shed. They would have found us for sure. We owe you our lives.
I still can't believe it. When we saw that ship, I thought it was all over.
It showed up right before the attack. Knew it was trouble the second I saw it, so we made a break for the sheds.
Smart. Attack details.
Tell me everything you remember about the attack.
The three of us were working the crops when that ship showed up. We just saw it and ran. I don't know what happened to the rest of the crew.
They were by the garage, over near the spaceport, right where that ship came down. No way they survived.
You don't know that. We survived. If they made it to the garage, they could have had a fighting chance.
Maybe.
Do you know anything about the Prothean beacon they dug up?
We're just farmers. We heard they found something out there, but it never really mattered to us. Not until now.
Of course. Beacon.
Do you know anything about the Prothean beacon they dug up?
We're just farmers. We heard they found something
Memory
out
of a
there,
goldfish.
But it never really mattered to us. Not until now.
Ship.
What else can you tell me about the ship you saw?
I was too busy running to get a clear look at it. I think it landed over near the spaceport.
Tell them about the noise, Cole. That awful noise.
It was emitting some kind of signal as it descended. It sounded like the shriek of the damned. Only it was coming from inside your own head.
Ah. Was it a jamming signal? No.
It was probably trying to block communications.
Whatever it was, felt like it was tearing right through my skull. Almost made it impossible to think.
I have to go.
Hey, Cole, we're just a bunch of farmers. These guys are soldiers. Maybe we should give them the stuff.
Jeez, Blake, you gotta learn when to shut up.
You should come clean.
You have something to tell me, Cole?
Some guys at the spaceport were running a small smuggling ring. Nothing major. In exchange for a cut of the profits, we let them store packages in our sheds.
Smuggling's a crime.
You're breaking the law, Cole.
We're not hurting anybody. Hell, most of the time I don't even know what's in the packages. Just thought there might be something we could use. I found a pistol. Figured it would come in handy if those things came back. But you'll probably get more use out of it than we will.
Is that all? Paragon.
We're risking our lives to save this colony. You sure there's nothing else in here that could help us out?
Yeah, there's one more thing. I was gonna sell it after this was over, but you probably deserve it more than I do.
Who's your contact at the spaceport, Cole? What's his name?
He's not a bad guy. I don't want to get him in trouble. Besides, I'm not a snitch.
He may know something. More Paragon.
He might have something to do with this whole attack, Cole. We need his name. It's important.
Yeah, okay, you're right. His name's Powell. Works the docks at the spaceport if he's still alive.
Okay.
I have to go.
Good luck.
I did not even look at what that was. Skill too low. Eh. this is why this game favors generic soldier. Is there anything down?
Heads up!
I'm a little busy here.
I think we got him, Commander.
Map. Let's see what we got going. Train station. I level up again. Damn, look at that. Basic armor. You can use your assault rifle because why not? Decryption. Electronics. Let's try that locker one more time. We might have enough. Hey, look at that. Shotgun, sniper rifle, take off. I forgot how clunky Mass Effect 1 was. I mean, this game is not aged well. The story is still, like, superb, but gameplay is... It leaves things
Commander,
to be desired.
It's Nihilus.
Metagel. Got anything over here? Upgrade kit.
I think we're good, Commander.
Nihilus.
Something's moving over behind those crates.
Wait! Don't shoot! I'm one of you! I'm human!
You need to be more careful.
Sneaking up on us like that nearly got you killed.
I am sorry. I was hiding from those creatures. My name's Pal. I saw what happened to that Turian. The other one shot him.
Tell me what happened.
I need to know how Nihilus died.
The other one got here first. He was waiting when your friend showed up. He called him Saren. I think they knew each other. Your friend seemed to relax. He let his guard down. And Saren killed him. Shot him right in the back. I'm just lucky he didn't see me behind the crates.
What about the beacon?
We were told a Prothean beacon was brought to the spaceport. What happened to it?
It's over on the other platform. Probably where that guy Saren was headed. He hopped on the cargo train right after he killed your friend.
Yeah, my dog's barking.
I knew that beacon was trouble. Everything's gone to hell since we found it. First that damn mothership showed up, then the attack. They killed everyone. Everyone. If I hadn't been behind the crates, I'd be dead too.
The Geth didn't find you?
How come you're the only one who survived? Why didn't anyone else try to hide behind the crates?
They never had a chance. I was already behind the crates when the attack started.
Wait a minute. You were hiding behind the crates before the attack?
Sometimes I need a nap to get through my shift. I sneak off behind the crates to grab 40 winks where the supervisor can't find me.
You survived because you're lazy?
Lucky brick.
If you hadn't snuck off for that nap, you'd probably be dead just like all the others.
Yeah. Yeah, I guess. I don't really want to think about it.
Cool mentioned you.
You're Cole's contact here on the docks. For the smuggling ring.
What? No! I mean, what does it matter now? So I'm a smuggler, who cares? My supervisor's dead, the entire crew's dead. Doesn't matter now, does it?
Smuggle any weapons?
Anything hidden nearby that we could use against the Geth?
A shipment of grenades came through last week. Nobody notices if a few small pieces go missing from the military orders.
You greedy son of a bitch! We're out here trying to protect your sorry ass, and all you can think about is how you can rip us off?
I never thought you'd actually need those grenades. Who'd want to attack Eden Prime? We're just a bunch of farmers. How was I supposed to know?
Let it go, Williams.
Forget about him. He's not worth it.
You're lucky the commander's here, pal. Hand over those grenades.
They're yours. Take them. My smuggling days are over, I swear.
You should make amends.
A lot of Marines died here, Powell. Those grenades could have come in handy. If I were you, I'd think of some way to make it up to them.
Yeah, okay. There is something else I was saving. Could be worth a fortune. Experimental technology, top of the line. Take it. I don't need it. I didn't want anyone to get hurt. Really, I'm sorry.
Emotional blackmail for being a good guy. The attack.
Tell me about the Geth attack.
It was quick. 1 minute, that ship was descending. The next, those Geth were swarming over the platform. Thousands of them. They must have been inside that mothership. They shot anything that moved. It was a massacre.
The beacon?
Is there anything else you can tell me about the beacon?
They brought it here this morning. We loaded it up onto the train and shipped it to the other platform. Hard to believe that was only a few hours ago. Feels like a whole other life.
And the ship.
Tell me about this mothership you saw.
I've never seen anything like it before. It was huge. Landed over near that platform. The whole place got dark as it came down. And it was making this noise, this sound that bored right into your brain. That's what woke me up. The attack came a few minutes later.
We need to find that beacon before it's too late.
Take the cargo train. That's where the other Turian went. I can't stay here. I need to get away from all this.
High explosive. You get more Paragon for a Paragon action. Crab battle. I like the way it says it's a destroyer, it's actually a friend. Or a type of friend, I guess. I can't remember, actually. Can you shut up here?
Not in the middle of a fight!
Totally in the middle of a fight. Great time to have a conversation. I hit him with warp. Okay. Just fire rip for a second. Maybe we'll use shotguns, wouldn't hurt either. Caden. Encryption. Make a quick save, you can't because I'm still in combat. Okay, I can save her. That was a weird audio glitch. Yeah. Train control.
Set the charges. Destroy the entire colony. Leave no evidence that we were here.
Spider diff.
Demolition charges. The Geth must have planted them.
Hurry! We need to find them all and shut them down.
That's above me. Swiggity swiggity, they're coming for my booty. Two's over there. Drive so easily, it's quite embarrassing, actually. Well, I suppose they are cheaper than before, so it makes sense. I suppose I'm just, like, so acquainted with the Mass Effect 3 versions of them, where they carry you a new one. Oh yeah, I forgot the abilities in Mass Effect 1 are just like floating discs. Ow. I'm gonna use this. Can't wait to get to Mass Effect 2 and do the Shadow Broker DLC.
So good!
It's like such a great DLC. If there's one DLC that you buy from Mass Effect 2, that's the DLC that you buy. They look a crate. With some very convenient loot. Take off. There, but not yet. Wouldn't it be more efficient to put like the charges around the facility or the colony to maximize damage? I mean, that makes sense. Makes sense to me at least. It's like trying to blow up a building, you put it on one floor, and yeah, okay, it'd blow up the floor and probably damage it, but if you put in the structural points, the beams, the steel beams or something like that, I don't know. Overload. Interesting. Anything to use over here?
Perimeter secured.
Metagel. Oh, it's the storage locker. What do you have to say, Ashley?
It used to be beautiful here.
Literally nothing. Thanks, Ashley, for being useless, really supporting the team. Okay, what do we got here? X, X, Y. These sequences, they get more, well, they get progressively more annoying and lengthy and annoying. Mostly annoying. Such a long prologue as well. Oh no, wait, there's one more crit. Glad I seen that, actually. Heavy Krogan, pistol sniper. Should probably start dismantling all of the sniper rounds, sniper rifles.
Normandy, the beacon is secure.
This is amazing. Actual working Prothean technology. Unbelievable.
It wasn't doing anything like that when they dug it up. Something must have activated it.
Roger, Normandy. Standing by.
Oh no!
No, don't touch him! It's too dangerous!
The fuck was that? I wonder. Visions, perhaps? Of some devastating thing?
We identified the ship that touched down on Eden Prime, the Normandy, a human alliance vessel. It was under the command of Captain Anderson. They managed to save the colony.
And the beacon.
One of the humans may have used it.
More robot than he was man. Than he is man now. Marturian, in this case.
Doctor! Dr. Chakwas! I think he's waking up.
No thanks to you.
You had us worried there, Shepard. How are you feeling?
Crap.
Minor throbbing. Nothing serious. How long was I out?
About 15 hours. Something happened down there with the beacon, I think.
It's my fault. I must have triggered some kind of security field when I approached it. You had to push me out of the way.
Don't blame yourself. Blame yourself.
You had no way to know what would happen.
Actually, we don't even know if that's what set it off. Unfortunately, we'll never get the chance to find out.
The beacon exploded. A system overload, maybe. The blast knocked you cold. The lieutenant and I carried you back here to the ship.
Shout out to that person.
I appreciate it.
Physically, you're fine. But I detected some unusual brain activity. Abnormal beta waves. I also noticed an increase in your rapid eye movement. Signs typically associated with intense dreaming.
I was dreaming?
I saw... I'm not sure what I saw. Death? Destruction? Nothing's really clear.
I better add this to my report. It may... Oh, Captain Anderson.
How's our exo holding up, Doctor?
Well, all the readings look normal. I'd say the command is going to be fine.
Glad to hear it. Shepard, I need to speak with you. In private.
Chop chop.
Aye aye, Captain. I'll be in the mess if you need me.
Sounds like that beacon hit you pretty hard, Commander. Are you sure you're okay?
I feel bad about Jenkins.
I don't like soldiers dying under my command.
Jenkins wasn't your fault. You did a good job, Shepard.
Why is Williams here?
Chief Williams isn't part of the Normandy crew.
I figured we could use a soldier like her. She's been reassigned to the Normandy.
Good.
Williams is a good soldier. She deserves...
No, she doesn't.
Lieutenant Elenko agrees with you. That's why I added her to our crew.
I'm pissed off about the gaff.
Intel dropped the ball, sir. We had no idea what we were walking into down there. That's why things went to hell.
The Geth haven't been outside the Vale in 2 centuries, Commander. Nobody could have predicted this.
But they should have.
You said you needed to see me in private, Captain?
I won't lie to you, Shepard. Things look bad. Nihlus is dead. The beacon was destroyed and Geth are invading. The Council's going to want answers.
Well, of course they are. We've got nothing to hide.
I didn't do anything wrong, Captain. Hopefully the Council can see that.
I'll stand behind you and your report, Shepard. You're a damned hero in my books. That's not why I'm here. It's Saren, that other Turian. Saren's a specter, one of the best, a living legend. But if he's working with the Geth, it means he's gone rogue. A rogue specter's trouble. Saren's dangerous, and he hates humans.
Oh, yeah. There's a few books about that. Haven't read them. Know about them. He hates humans?
Why?
He thinks we're growing too fast, taking over the galaxy. A lot of aliens think that way. Most of them don't do anything about it. But Saren has allied himself with the Geth. I don't know how, I don't know why. I only know it had something to do with that beacon. You were there just before that beacon self-destructed. Did you see anything? Any clue that might tell us what Saren was after?
A vision.
Just before I lost consciousness, I had some kind of vision.
A vision? A vision of what?
Our death? War? Well, actually, these are all right, so...
I saw synthetics. Geth, maybe. Slaughtering people. Butchering them.
We need to report this to the Council, Shepard.
What will we say? I had a bad dream?
What are we gonna tell him? I had a bad dream?
That's convenient.
We don't know what information was stored in that beacon. Lost Prothean technology? Blueprints for some ancient weapon of mass destruction? Whatever it was. Saren took it. But I know Saren. I know his reputation is politics. He believes humans are a blight on the galaxy. This attack was an act of war. He has the secrets from the beacon. He has an army of Geth at his command, and he won't stop until he's wiped humanity from the face of the galaxy.
You're right.
I'll find some way to take him down.
It's not that easy.
Yes, it is.
He's a specter. He can go anywhere, do almost anything. That's why we need the Council on our side.
Understood, sir.
We prove Saren's gone rogue, and the Council will revoke his specter status.
I'll contact the ambassador and see if he can get us an audience with the Council. He'll want to see us as soon as we reach the Citadel. We should be getting close. Head up to the bridge and tell Joker to bring us into dock.
Oh, bugger. Okay. Need to modify my loadout regardless.
Hey, Commander.
Ashley.
I'm glad you're okay, Commander. The crew could use some good news after what happened to Jenkins.
He'll be missed.
Jenkins was a valuable part of this crew.
No, it wasn't.
Part of me feels guilty over what happened. If Jenkins was still alive, I might not be here.
You earned it. Not really.
You're a good soldier, Williams. You belong on the Normandy.
Thanks, Commander. That means a lot from you. I've never met anyone who was awarded the Star of Terra.
How are you holding up?
Things were pretty rough down there. Are you okay?
I've seen friends die before. Comes with being a Marine. But to see my whole unit wiped out. And you never get used to seeing dead civilians. But things would have been a lot worse if you hadn't shown up.
Hey, you helped, sort of.
We couldn't have done it without you, Williams.
Thanks, Commander. I have to admit, I was a little worried about being assigned to the Normandy. It's nice when someone makes you feel welcome.
Glad to have you.
I think you're gonna fit in here just fine, Williams.
Thanks, Commander.
She's got a whole story going on there.
Yes, Commander? Is there something you need?
Personal questions.
How did you end up serving on an Alliance ship?
I enlisted right out of med school. Earth always seemed boring to me. Too safe. Too secure. I figured the colonies were teeming with exotic adventure. I wanted to travel the stars, tending the wounds of tough soldiers with piercing eyes and sensitive souls. Turns out military life isn't quite as romantic as I'd imagined. But humanity needs the Alliance if we want to keep expanding through the Traverse, and the Alliance always needs good doctors. So I stayed on to do my part.
Any regrets?
Ever think you made the wrong choice?
Sometimes I think about opening a private practice back on Earth, or maybe taking a position at one of the new med centers out in the colonies. But there's something special about working on soldiers. If I left the Alliance now, I'd feel like I was abandoning them.
Duh. Captain Anderson.
What do you know about Captain Anderson?
I've served with him for a few tours now. He knows when to let things slide and when to crack the whip. The crew knows he's seen pretty much anything they'll ever run into. And he cares about the people under his command.
He's a good man. Kieran Alinko.
How well do you know the lieutenant?
I'd never worked with him before this mission. But he has an impressive service record. Over a dozen special commendations. Tends to keep to himself, though. Maybe because of the headaches. It's not easy being an L2.
An L2?
What does that have to do with it?
Well, most biotics now use the L3 implants. Lieutenant Alinko was wired with the old L2 configuration. Sometimes there are complications.
Such as?
What kind of complications?
Severe mental disabilities, insanity, crippling physical pain. There's a long list of horrific side effects. Caden's lucky. He just gets migraines.
Oh, lucky. Yeah. Nothing possibly bad could happen.
I should go.
Goodbye, Commander.
I should go. Caden.
Glad to see you're okay, Commander.
Thanks for the chat. Anderson.
Go speak to Joker when you're ready. Tell him to bring the Normandy into dock.
They done their best to try to make this feel alive. I mean, given the time the game was out, it was, but in hindsight, it's just so not adequate. I'm going to go modify my loadout before I talk to Joker, who is, by the way, the MVP. Everybody loves Joker. Even Joker loves Joker. Inconspicuous loading screen is inconspicuous. I mean, it's better than running down a hill and getting two loading screens. Normandy's vehicle bay allows you to manage your crew's inventory using a squad member's equipment locker, allows you to alter their weapons, blah, 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 blah. Blah, blah, blah. Buying things from him costs more, if I recall correctly. Caden's locker. Here, blah, blah, blah. I mean, you're going to be using biotics, aren't you? You can take that, I'll take the other one. You look weird, but that's perfectly fine. Accuracy, damage. I'll take that shotgun. You can take an Avenger. Where the hell's mine, anyway? I believe, like, mine's over here or something like that. I think. Codex.
Hey, Commander. Looking for some extra supplies before you head out?
Supplies?
What have you got?
Whatever you want. Armor, weapons, mods. It's not standard Alliance issue, but that's not necessarily a bad thing. Well, as long as you don't mind paying for it.
Pay you?
Why should I pay you for my weapons and armor?
My stuff doesn't come from the Alliance. I have to purchase it myself, and it's not cheap. Hell, the licenses alone have set me back more than I'd like. But no licenses, no goods. Without the goods, I'm out of a job.
Investigate. Licenses.
What are licenses? Why do you need them?
Manufacturers sell licenses. Each license allows me to buy and sell a certain brand of products. I already have several basic ones, but you'll need to buy more if you want me to bring in different brands. Many of the best licenses are hard to get, but they're well worth the cost if you can find them.
Manufacturers?
What do the different manufacturers offer?
There are too many for me to keep track of, but each license will explain what it's good for.
New items.
How often will you get new items?
Well, that depends on how many licenses you've purchased. But I'll rotate items on a regular basis regardless. And anytime we land someplace with a big enough port, I'll buy, sell, and trade whatever I can. Check back often. I need to move items quickly, so only the most basic items will be stocked consistently.
Roger, Dodger.
Not right now, thanks.
No problem. Keep checking back.
Okay, where's my nut? Trying to remember. Unless it's in a locker, then that would make sense. Examine the core. Examine that. More codex stuff. Shadows. Yes, it is. Okay. I need to try to find my locker. There's only six there. Get six squad mates, so it's not here. Bugger. Well, that's gonna put a, difficult twist on things. I mean, that's what Google's for, but pretty sure you don't want to hear typing in the background. That'd be annoying. That'd be annoying for anybody. But that requirement for skills, like I was trying to use my sniper rifle and it wouldn't let me because I didn't have the required skill. That goes away in Mass Effect 2 or 3, I'm not entirely sure. Shepherd's Locker, it's right here. Covered items, take off. Plenty's Omnigel. Where the hell do I go to wait, can I modify my loadout before? Okay, that would make more sense if I could do that before I deploy. God dang it. Anything down here? Nada. Okay. We get to go to Joker. Oh my god. Saying often, we'll just pretend that I knew this the entire time and I'm not actually a dumbass. Most of the Avenger does more damage, but okay, that makes more sense. Shotguns. Just better overall. Sniper rifle's not really gonna matter. Oh, Joker. Make another quick save real quick so I don't have to go back and repeat things all over again, because that's always a blast.
I'm glad you're okay, Commander. Losing Jenkins was hard enough on the crew.
I don't believe I can use the galaxy map right now. Yep, manual. Nothing else. Okay.
JFK.
Airlock.
Good timing, Commander. I was just about to bring us into the Citadel. See that taxpayer money at work.
Okay. So, there's probably two times this relay cutscene stuff is actually important. Or three times. It's one of them.
Size isn't everything.
Why so touchy, Joker?
I'm just saying, you need firepower too.
Giggity.
Look at that monster. Its main gun could rip through the barriers in any ship in the Alliance fleet.
Good thing it's on our side then.
Citadel Control, this is SSV Normandy. Requesting permission to land. Oh.
Stand by for clearance, Normandy.
I keep hitting my pop filter.
Clearance granted. You may begin your approach. Transferring you to an Alliance operator.
Roger, Alliance Tower.
Normandy, this is Alliance Tower. Please proceed to Dock 422.
This is an outrage! The Council would step in if the Geth attacked a Turian colony!
The Turians don't found colonies on the borders of the Terminus systems, Ambassador.
Humanity was well aware of the risks when you went into the Traverse.
What about Saren? You can't just ignore a rogue Spectre. I demand action!
You don't get to make demands of a Council, Ambassador.
Citadel Security is investigating your charges against Saren. We will discuss the CSEC findings at the hearing, not before.
Politics.
Captain Anderson, I see you brought half your crew with you.
Just the ground team from Eden Prime, in case you had any questions.
I have the mission reports. I assume they're accurate?
They are. Sounds like you convinced the Council to give us an audience.
They were not happy about it. Saren's their top agent. They don't like him being accused of treason.
He's dangerous.
Saren's a threat to every human colony out there. He needs to be stopped. The Council has to listen to us.
Settle down, Commander. You've already done more than enough to jeopardize your candidacy for the Spectres.
Blow me.
The mission on Eden Prime was a chance to prove you could get the job done. Instead, Nihilus ended up dead and the beacon was destroyed.
Blow me.
That's Saren's fault, not his.
Then we better hope the CSEC investigation turns up evidence to support our accusations. Otherwise, the Council might use this as an excuse to keep you out of the Spectres. Come with me, Captain. I want to go over a few things before the hearing. Shepard, you and the others can meet us at the Citadel Tower, top level. I'll make sure you have clearance to get in.
And that's why I hate politicians.
Oh, Dean is just a piece of shit. Your map, key locations, your radar, I want to get the direction. Right, way it's pointing. Okay. Easy decryption. That's convenient. Unusual energy readings during the patrol of the Argus Rail Cluster. She had particular concerns about the Hydra system, but it was recalled before her team could investigate further and the patrols scheduled in this sector to what is in a recon team. That might have something to do with something, but I actually can't remember.
Confidence, and she betrayed that confidence.
meantime, do not do anything rash.
Alcor have a way of expressing their personality in a very expressionless way.
Hello there, human. Sincere apology, but I am here on business and cannot be distracted right now.
What's wrong?
You seem distressed. Is there something I can do to help?
Alarmed response. You overheard that, did you? This is all going so wrong, and it is the Asari consort's fault. She's the one who started all this.
What happened?
What did this Asari do to get you so upset?
I cannot speak more about this problem. It is too sensitive. Suffice it to say, she has compromised my authority as a diplomat.
You did that yourself. Yourself. Where is she?
Where can I find this Asari consort?
She is across the bridge from here. Her offices are easy enough to spot. Good day, human.
Likewise.
Pleased greeting. Human, it is always good to see your kind. I am Ambassador Kalen. Genuine query. Is there something I can do for you this day?
Let's see. Your speech.
Why do you explain what you're about to say?
Our people communicate less through words and more through scent and slight movements. Plainly, we discovered our vocal expression was not enough to convey the feelings of our conversations to other species.
Why do you bother, Kalen? These Earth Clan don't really care about our ways.
Remorseful response, Din. You don't truly believe that, and if you do, I am very sorry for you.
I love Alcor. The Ballis are, well, they're potatoes to begin with.
Tell me more about your species.
Genuine enthusiasm. I delight in telling the history of my people. It is agreeable to share our culture with others.
History.
Tell me about the history and origins of the Alcor.
The Alcor were just beginning to explore Council space when the Asari first made contact with us. With their help, we discovered the relay closest to our system, and from there the Citadel. Proudly, within one lifetime we established a regular route to the Citadel, and quickly became one of the more active species living on this great station.
Culture?
I'd like to know more about the culture of the Alcor.
Frankly, we Alcor prefer the safety and familiarity of our own colonies to the confines of space travel. Our society is built on small, tight-knit groups, though we are always welcoming to outsiders. Our government tends to be very stable. Our people are not very comfortable with sudden changes.
Yeah, getting that feeling. Your ambassador?
What do you do here?
Modestly, I work to bring the problems and the requests of the Alcor groups to the attention of the Council.
They only give us these positions to keep us quiet. The Council doesn't care about our races.
Chastising rebuke. Your tone is inappropriate, Din. This human is not to blame for your malcontent or your misconceived suspicions.
Indeed, I'm not. Well, thank you.
Goodbye, Ambassador.
Sincere farewell. Good day to you, human. Enjoy your time on the Citadel.
Hello, Din, you little...
Earth Clan, you are in the wrong place, I think. Your ambassador is next door in the large office.
Chastising remark. Don't be so rude, Din. At least introduce yourself.
I am Din Korlak, Volus Ambassador. Is there something I can do for you, Earth Clan?
See, he made a point of saying that we've got the large office, and I'm getting this feeling that there's something about size that matters to this individual.
What is this place?
You are in the embassy for the Volus and the Alcor.
Your ambassador is next door, in his own office.
in this shared space, I aid my fellow Volus when I'm not being interrupted.
Blow me. I mean, we got the head hide for it, so I mean, it's completely possible.
I'd like to know more about the Volus.
I'm sure our history and culture would bore you, EarthClan.
I want to kick him. But, I mean, like, I could push him over or down a hill, and he would just, like, the momentum would just keep picking up. Oh, that's the fourth time I have hit this pop filter. I need to reposition that.
Actually, I would like to know more about your history.
My people came to the Citadel shortly after the Asari and Salarians had discovered it. We were instrumental in establishing a standardized galactic economy. However, despite our long association with the Citadel and our many contributions to galactic society, we still do not hold a seat on the Council.
Well, it would be more like a high stool, but yeah, sure.
Tell me about Volus culture.
We are tribal by nature, but our ways are not violent. We barter and trade our lands and tribe members in order to increase status. Larger tribes often engulf smaller ones and eventually split again. Our society is very malleable, and our government is always shifting and changing. Since we're not physically adept, we trade our services for protection.
So, you're like economic prostitutes. That makes sense.
What is it you do here?
I look out for the best interests of the Volus people. No easy task, considering how often we are overlooked by the Council.
Chastising rebuke, Din. The Council favors your species greatly.
You are naive. The Earth Clan will be invited to the Council long before our species will.
Council admittance.
Why aren't the Volus or Elcor part of the Council?
All species must prove themselves before they join the Council. All but the Earth Clans, it would seem.
Dismissive. Ignore the Volus ambassador, human. He is incorrect in his assessment.
Really? How long have we been waiting? How long do you think we'll continue to wait? Bah, this talk is wasted on the humans.
Maybe you should just luck up to us a little bit more, you know? Learn something from us by lucking up to us. You know, from the whole way down there. That's a thing. Anyway, why so cranky?
You seem to have a bit of a chip on your shoulder, Din.
You humans are new to the Citadel, and yet the Council has granted you great favor.
Chastising rebuke, Din. Your species has always been granted many concessions. Volus territory has expanded tenfold since coming to the Citadel.
Details. We still have no real say in the decisions that affect Citadel space.
See, that's my line. I should go.
Goodbye, Ambassador.
Yes, yes. Good day, Earth Clan.
Keepers. See, those guys are creepy. Nobody knows anything about them. Well, I mean, now we know things about them, but we didn't know anything about them. Stairs, which means that's locked. That's exactly what that means. Yes. The AI. No, that's not Cortana.
Welcome to the Presidio.
It's Avena.
Allow me to be your guide.
Good day, Commander. The human ambassador is up the stairs, first room on the right.
Embassy receptionist. I was close. Commander.
You know who I am?
Yes, I receive reports on all newly arrived dignitaries and notable people.
Yeah, I'm notable. Look at that location.
What is this place?
This is the Presidium. More specifically, you are at the Citadel Embassies. If you have more questions, please access Avena.
Avena?
What's that?
Oh, Avena is the virtual guide for the Citadel. Feel free to access the terminal yourself.
I'm gonna have to for the sake of the playthrough, but she's really useless. Personal question.
What's your name? What do you do here?
My name is Sephiria. I'm the administrative assistant for the embassies.
Busy. Wink, wink. Cough, cough.
You seem to be distracted.
The embassies are the hub of all Citadel politics. When you represent trillions of citizens, it tends to get a little busy.
I'm sure it does. Hasta la pasta.
I should be going now.
Have a pleasant day.
What have we got up here? I actually completely forget, so... it's a revelation to me as well. Diplomat.
I can't believe I landed a job here. This place is fantastic.
Codex. The hell is that?
Human, delighted, welcome. It is good to meet you.
Seems so forced. Human, I'm delighted. It's a pleasure to meet you. Yes, yes. Executor Palin.
Commander Shepard. I didn't expect to see you here. Did Ambassador Udina send you?
No. Who are you?
Have we met before?
No, but I know you well enough. I'm Executor Palin, head of CSEC. It's my job to know when someone like you arrives on the Citadel.
Dick.
Was there something you needed, Commander?
Attitude towards humans.
I get the feeling you're not too fond of humans.
No, I just don't trust your kind. Not yet. You humans are eager to take all the power you can get, and you're being given a lot. If the Council wants to make humanity their new favorite pet, that's their business. But I don't have to like it.
We're not favorites, Dad.
The Council treats us like second-class citizens. We have to fight for everything we get.
Good. Then fight for it. But don't expect the rest of us to just sit back and let you take it. I'm a busy man, Commander. Are we done here?
Turians have like a militaristic sort of culture, so you know, it's sort of to be expected. They're like North Korea, but they're not like North Korea. That makes no sense.
What do you know about the Spectres?
They're the right hand of the Council, or so they like to be called. More like the underhanded side of the Council.
You don't like them?
What do you have against the Spectres?
I can't abide any organization that considers itself above the law. Especially when it's left up to each individual Spectre to decide when and how to bend the rules.
It's a bit naive.
Sometimes you have to bend the law to keep people safe.
I've been with CSEC for 30 years. I've never had to break the law to do my job, not once.
Yeah, right. You expect us to believe none of your officers are corrupt?
There are over 200,000 CSEC agents. Some of them are going to be bad. But we don't turn a blind eye to corruption like the Spectres do. We do our best to find and punish any officer who breaks the law. Spectres. They'll never come under that kind of scrutiny.
Spectres are important, though.
The galaxy needs people like that. People who do the dirty jobs.
I agree. But they need to be held to a higher standard. They need to be accountable. Saren's out of control. We both know that. But because he's a Spectre, the Council doesn't want to do anything about it. Is that the kind of person this galaxy needs?
No.
But not all Spectres are like Saren.
True. But the potential is always there.
Also true. CSEC.
Tell me about CSEC.
CSEC provides necessary police and security services throughout the Citadel. We're a civilian government agency, though many of our members have had military training. Of course, as the CSEC representative to the Council, I spend most of my time liaising between the two.
Ah, fun times. Investigation.
Tell me about your investigation into Saren.
Sorry, Commander. I don't make a habit of giving out details about ongoing investigations.
It was worth a try.
I'll be going now.
Goodbye, Commander.
He's a bit of a dick. But he's a nice dick. Easy decryption. I almost choked. This is the transmission of interest when we contact multiple recipients across the extranet. Further monitoring of the situation is warranted. My fellow biotic, we have been selected to receive this transmission because of our shared plight. If you understand us, fear tolerate us. We must stand together. We must build our own new world. Come join us at the Hawk and Ita cluster. Only as a body can we right the wrongs done to our kind. So yeah, Biotics have like a really fucked up history as well. I forget which planet it was, I think it was Mars. But what happened, let me talk to these two. What happened was some organizations discovered Element Zero, which is like a really big thing in Mass Effect. It's like fuel, it's used for Biotics. Well, it was used to trigger Biotics. Basically some people were like, hey, you know what would be really fucked up? A bunch of Biotic stuff, Element Zero, we'll just drop it over the human population on this planet. That's exactly what he done. Fucked up a lot of people, a bunch of people got cancer, a bunch of people died, but some people got abilities, like Kidan right there, and apparently Shepard, because I'm doing a Biotic build, and that's basically a whole new thing, so, yeah. There's more details on it if you want to look it up online. I'm not going to, like, bore you by going through the Codex and the Journal stuff, because there's a lot of stuff. Diplomat, hello.
This place seems strange. I wish there were more humans around.
Giggity.
Don't believe the rumors. Consort would never reveal her secrets.
Or would she?
Of course she wouldn't. She'd be tossed out the nearest airlock if she did. I suppose. Besides, Nick, the consort's nothing like the girls back on the colonies. She's...
You don't have to do it with her. You can just talk to her if you want.
Is that all you did, Jazz? Just talk?
I didn't say that.
Ha! I bet you did too.
Shut up, Fredericks.
Yeah, Fredericks. Shut up.
What do you want? Oh, Commander. Is there something I can do for you?
Relax, Private. This isn't an inspection.
Right, sorry. What can I do for you, Commander?
Stop being a little bitch and probably tell me about the consort.
What can you tell me about the Asari consort?
Well, she's an Asari who works here as... That is, she helps people with things.
You never went to see her, did you, Fredericks?
No, I never did. I couldn't afford it. It costs half a year's credits just to go in and talk to her.
Where is she?
Can you at least tell me where I can find her?
Sure. She's across the bridge from the embassies.
Thanks, kid. Have fun. Try not to get into too much trouble.
I will. Have fun, that is.
Nobody's gonna give him any form of crap. That's impressive.
I don't have time to talk now. I'm very busy.
I'll be back.
Hello, Commander. Can I get you something?
Why not?
What have you got?
Information, mostly. Would you like to know about some points of interest nearby?
Fill me in.
What's going on around here?
Well, you found the embassies. Not much going on here. Across the bridge, you'll find the bank, the Emporium, and Shiera's. If you haven't heard of her, you soon will. If you need supplies, you can try the markets one level below. For entertainment, I'd try Flux or Cora's Den.
Shiera's.
What is Shiera's?
The consort? She entertains clients who can afford her services. Most of the diplomats and ambassadors have visited her at one time or another. She's a very powerful woman, but also very respected.
You know, fun fact, in the Wild West, according to the whole, I'm trying to remember, but Ruins Everything show, hookers out west, like, in the old, you know, Wild Wild West, actually had a lot of power, so, you know, fun fact for you.
Tell me about Flux and Cora's Den.
Well, Flux has gambling and dancing, certainly more lively than this place. Cora's Den, on the other hand, well, let's just say it's livelier and deadlier, all at the same time.
Uh-huh. I should go.
Goodbye.
I should go.
So long, Commander. Have a pleasant day.
Likewise, sir. Likewise. There's nobody to talk to in here. Another keeper. I remembered there's a quest where you need to scan keepers. And I remember there was one that gave me a lot of trouble. And I was just trying to find the little bugger. Okay, so.
Welcome to the Presidium. Allow me to be your guide.
You too. I am going to save right here and call it quits for now. If you guys like this type of video, you know, the long plays, let me know. I'm probably going to keep doing it for the sake of, you know, completing this playthrough, and I'll probably do that up until Andromeda. If it picks up some attention by then, you know, I'll do Andromeda as well, you know, some other games. But the only way to know is to let me know down below. And that's like, write your thoughts and stuff, and if you're interested, that's great. But I need to know, because doing this, it's timely, and there's only a certain amount of time on a day when I can do these types of videos. So I need to know, and the only way to do that, once again, is to let me know down below. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to do the thing where you click the button and absolutely destroy that like button, like fucking smash that button. If you didn't, be sure to leave a dislike. If you're not sure, just try some stuff, and, you know, I'll get back to you. But that's pretty much it. Ladies and gents, thank you very much for watching. As always, I've been SOLIDSNAKEE, and I shall speak you all next time.